मेनली हाँ हैबिटेट इज द प्लेस वेयर इट इज अ नेचुरल ड्वेलिंग प्लेस फॉर ऑर्गेनिज्म. यस यस यू आर राइट. सो जस्ट वेट लेट मी कंप्लीट. एंड टाइप्स ऑफ हैबिटेट मेनली यस टेरेस्ट्रियल दैट इज अ हैबिटेट ऑन लैंड इज कॉल्ड टेरेस्ट्रियल हैबिटेट. दैट इज इन वॉटर इज कॉल्ड द एक्वेटिक हैबिटेट. एंड यू नो सम ऑफ द that is like the birds they most of the time they depend that they spend the time in the air they are also called the aerial habitat okay so mainly broadly habitats are of two types one is terrestrial and the other one is aquatic yes Devanshi now tell
ma'am a habitat is a
yes Devanshi complete that if you are eating something it's a time you have got three periods to eat if you are eating you don't have to talk anything
I'm not eating anything.
Yes, I know. Your sounds is coming and I know. Why do animals need to adapt to their surrounding? Next question, raise your hands. Other than those who have answered. Why do animals need to adapt to their surrounding? Yes? No one, only Ankita. Dipta, yes?
Ma'am, so that they could like live there and just find the foods and
survive
in the surroundings and they can adapt themselves to the surrounding.
So they need to adapt means they have to accommodate in that situation. So why? Yes, for their survival, so that they can live over there, they can just have their food over there, and they can also reproduce over there. Okay. That is the generation will go on over that place. Next, write short notes on adaptive features of camel, fish, and cactus. One by one. Camel, adaptive features of camel. Nancy.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Nancy.
Ma'am, the hump of camel store fat. Ma'am, second, they have padded feet. Third, have thick, long eyes. Eyelashes. They can survive in extreme condition when water and food are so scarce. Six, they sweat less to prevent water loss.
So they sweat less to prevent water loss. Just you think that question or all the points that has been told by Nancy, you have to give why. So first she has told about that the hump stores fat. Yes, Ankita, why?
Ma'am, so that when food and water is scarce, basically when energy is scarce, ma'am, it uses the fat in the hump to back up energy. Ma'am, it can burn.
Okay, that is respire. That is food is required, you know. It can burn that fat deposited in the hump and they can supply water and food to the body or water and energy to the body. Not only food,
backup energy.
Yes, it's a backup energy. Yes. And next point, they are having eyelashes. Dipta, why they're having long eyelashes? Please do all raise your hand so that I can. Why the camels are having long eyelashes? I have asked Dipta.
So the dust particles don't get into the eyes.
So yes, to prevent the dust particles from entering the eye. Yes, Ashmita. Next one. Why they're having that padded foot?
I cannot answer this question.
Why, Ashmita? Kyun hai padded foot? Kyun hai? Yes, Agam.
Mom.
Agam.
Mom, because they can walk on the like. The in desert it is very hot and the sand become hot so they walk on that hot sand they have the padded feet
so during the daytime due to the scorching ray of the sun is a very good conductor of heat and the sand becomes heated up and it's really too hot for anyone to keep the feet over there as a result the
ma'am,
camels are having
also, ma'am,
yes beaches also we have felt hai na
yes,
hum log jab
ma'am.
Jate to hum
it's
bihar.
So hot yes. It's really hard to stand ma'am I literally play hopscotch
like that
yes ma'am
so that is why if you just you have a slipper on the beach you can easily walk and similarly the camels are having that pad that is a bad conductor of heat as a result they can walk long distance on the surface of the sand yes Devanshi any other point put on your video
ma'am.
Everyone I want to see your faces Yes, Devanshi.
Ma'am, so the camels have the padded feet because
You have done. No,
sand.
Padded feet I have given you. Any other extra features that camels are having?
Ma'am, can I answer?
Ma'am, they excrete less urine and
yes.
they produce dry dung.
Very good.
Because,
yes, they
because of
there
the
is scarcity,
loss.
Because they
because,
want to prevent the water loss, because there is in the desert there is huge scarcity of water. As a result,
yes.
they urinate less, and also the dung that are produced, the fecal outputs are also very dry. Yes, Shivam. Any other points?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Ma'am, they sweat less.
Just one by one. I have asked Shivam. Shivam is now talking. Wait, children. Yes. Shivam.
Ma'am, they sweat less.
They sweat less again to prevent water loss. Yes, Aradhana.
Ma'am, they.
You can start writing, children. Those questions have been discussed, and all these points should be there. These are revision only, hai na? But about aqua agar,
ma'am.
Yes, Aradhana. Just
to
wait. Devanshi, wait.
Of camel to eat spiny foods.
They can eat spiny food because there is not natural vegetation is not there, and you know there the leaves have been converted into spines. And the stems produces the or carry on
yeah.
photosynthesis. So the camel, the mouth inside the camel is should be so much thick so that the tongue could not get pierced by those spines. Okay, yes, they are taking spiny. Very good. Okay, so done. Anything else? One more point I need. Yes, Ashmita.
Ma'am, camels have long legs which help to keep their bodies away from the heat.
Away from the hot ground. Away from the hot sandy ground. Yes, Aryan, anything else?
Ma'am, their tongues are well developed to chew the spicy food. And ma'am, one more. They can drink a lot of water at a time.
They drink and a lot of water.
Ma'am, 30 gallons of water at a time.
Yes.
Ma'am, and ma'am,
ma'am,
I have another
one
point.
More very important
ma'am,
point. Ma'am, there's one more.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, so the...
Can I answer?
Yes, Ankita.
Ma'am, there's one more very important point. Ma'am, they're forgetting about the coats of the camel. Ma'am, they have short and tidy coats in the summer to keep them cool. And ma'am, longer and hairy coats in the winter to keep them warm.
So camels, mainly desert are two types of deserts are there. That the cold desert and hot desert. So hot desert doesn't have that woolly coating. But the camels in the cold desert, they are having. Yes, yes, you can add. Next,
ma'am,
fish.
Ma'am, there's one
yes.
more point about the
Devanshi.
Camel.
Yes, Devanshi.
Ma'am, they actually store water in their some kind of blood vessels.
No.
Some kind of blood.
Blood is having a huge percentage of water. This doesn't store it. It circulates.
Yes, ma'am. And ma'am,
yes.
one
okay.
more thing.
Yes.
Ma'am, their legs are very high so that their body remains away from the sand.
We have discussed. Ashmita has given the point. Yes. So next is fish.
And
that is adaptation. Yes.
Question.
Yes, you have to write the questions. Yes, next. Arpit, start with. What are the adaptations in fish? Or adaptive features in fishes.
Ma'am.
Arpit, put on your video and give the answer. Everyone put on your video. Haan, bolo Arpit. Fish ka kya characteristics hai that help them to sleep, swim? Yes. Unmute yourself. Kuch bhi nahi aa raha hai. Fishes are having legs. So first tell what the fishes have. Arpit, bolo kya hai fishes ke paas for swimming. How do they swim?
Ma'am, by her tail.
Akshara. Akshara.
Ma'am, can I?
Akshara. Akshara has raised the hand. Yes, Akshara.
Ma'am, they have streamlined body.
They have streamlined body.
Ma'am,
yes.
They have streamlined body. Ma'am, is tails on?
They have scales on their body so that water cannot enter the body. Okay. They prevent. Yes, Aryan. Any other?
Mom.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am.
They have gills so that from that they can breathe.
Breathe in water. They can
ma'am,
breathe in
the dissolved
water.
Oxygen.
Present in the water. They can breathe from there. Ayush Pade. Any other point? Ayush.
Can I?
One
Ayush.
More.
Ma'am, just one more point. Ma'am, I'd like
ma'am,
to add.
Ma'am, no, ma'am.
Just wait, one by one. I'm not able to. Just wait. Raise your hand. Ma'am. Yes, Shivam. Shivam.
No. Ma'am, they have fins to change the direction.
They are having fins which helps to change the direction. Yes, Nancy, any other? Tail fins
balance in water.
They can balance their. Yes. Tail fin helps to change the direction. Yes, Dipta.
Ma'am, the gills helps in oxidation.
Gills helps in?
Ma'am, to take oxygen.
So, this is not oxidation. Exchange of gas. Helps in exchange of gas. What is it?
Yes, ma'am.
When the blood is passing through the gills, let me draw. So, the gills are like this. Do you remember I told you to draw? Are you able to see?
So yes, ma'am.
There is blood vessels. There is blood vessels inside. So what happens when this gills comes in contact with water? What will happen? These bloods are having more carbon dioxide. So CO2. Yesterday, you remember? Day before yesterday, we have learned some formula. CO2 ma'am, is carbon yes, dioxide. Yes, so CO2 will come out in water. So CO2 will come in water, and from water the dissolved oxygen will go into the gills.
Ma'am,
so this is called oxygen. This is called exchange of gas.
Exchange of gas.
Yes, ma'am. So exchange of
gas. The gases are exchanged. That is between oxygen and carbon dioxide, both are getting exchanged. One is coming and the other one is going out.
Ma'am, can
you
give another point?
Yes, you can.
Ma'am, fishes have slippery scales on their body.
Yes, those scales are having some mucus on their body and slaves.
Ma'am,
the scales
their body is slippery,
prevent
ma'am.
Prevent the water from outside to enter
and
the body of the fish.
नहीं
तो क्या होता? आप लोग कभी कभी हाथ में पानी में हाथ रख. If you just all of you have maybe have swim in the swimming pool. If you are doing or just in the swimming pool for more than an hour, you will see your hands will get swell up. हो जाता है ना swell up.
Ma'am, wrinkled.
Yes. So water enters. Okay. So what is it? If the fishes are also like our skin, they will have their body will also get swelled up like that. So to prevent that, they are having that scales, layer of scales and mucus, which prevents water from outside to enter their body. नहीं तो फूल जाता है एकदम.
Yes.
कभी कभी brushed हो. They can brushed. But that doesn't happen. Clear?
Ma'am, actually, I've noticed that on my fishes, ma'am. When the scales appear shiny also, ma'am. Sometimes.
Yes,
ma'am.
When they zoom past, we can see that it shines. It shines.
Yes.
Ma'am, because the body is slippery, that's why it shines.
Yes, for slippery, that's why it's, yes, and it's shiny also. It's very smooth also. The scales are very smooth.
Different colors.
Yes.
Okay. Different color is not a that is a feature, additive feature. Okay. Next, cactus. Harshit Kumar Shukla. Harshit Kumar Shukla. Harshit Kumar Shukla. Arpit Akshara. Just go through the question. Third part of the third. Dekho. Abhi abhi am. You just tell that. So less questions we have given. It is getting time. You have to come. Yes, Nancy. Features.
Can I answer?
Harshita wants to answer. Let Nancy give some points. Yes, Nancy.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, first, leaves have been converted into spines. Second, the steam performs the function of leaf. Third, the steam is covered by
it's
a
not
thick
steam, bacteria. It's stem, stem, stem. So every line you're telling, you have to give the reason. The leaves have been converted into spines. Why? To prevent or to check transpiration. The stems are fleshy. Why? They are green in color. Why? To produce food. They contain chlorophyll so that they can produce food. Yes, Agam. Bolo.
Ma'am, they have long root to take water from underground.
Yes, as the soil doesn't hold water. Soil is having no holding capacity of water. So what is happening? Water is getting, they will get water much, much below the layer. So they are having strong root system to take water. Yes, Ankita.
Ma'am, I was asking that for question number 3. Ma'am, how many points do we have to write minimum?
As minimum 3 to 4. Okay?
Ma'am.
But if you get time, if you're having time, You can write as many as your revision. I need.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Ma'am, actually, my gel pens are over, so I'm writing with a ball pen. It's really hard to
no
write.
Problem. No problem. What do you mean by acclimatization? It's given in your book. You are able to do. I think all of you have read the blue patch. The
and
yes, Devanshi.
Taught us in the difference earlier about acclimatization and adaptation.
Yes, adaptation. So you are able to write.
Can I answer?
I asked Devanshi. Devanshi will able to, otherwise Ankita will answer.
Ma'am, can I?
Harshita, yes? Who is telling can I?
Ma'am, Harshita was telling.
Ma'am, I'm telling a point on cactus, adaption in cactus.
Bolo.
Ma'am, I'm telling a point on cactus. Its stem is covered with a thick waxy layer to retain water.
To check water loss. Yes, Ankita, come to the next point. Tell me. Acclimatization.
Acclimatization is a process of adapting to its habitat, to its living surroundings. Ma'am, adaptation is already being adapted. Ma'am, it already lives there. Ma'am,
naturally,
adaptation
when you're
is a
born
natural
and...
process. Hmm. And ma'am, but... acclimatization is more like an artificial process, ma'am, that they have to acclimatize, ma'am. But adaptation is from the beginning.
So, normally, the acclimatization in a place is not the natural habitat of that organism, okay? But in case of adaptation, that was a natural habitat. But sometimes some animals are shifted from one place to another place. Then those animals have to acclimatize.
Ma'am,
okay?
Migrations.
Or we are shifting from one place to another place like that. Okay?
Ma'am, like
here?
Us, ma'am, like us army kids, we have to acclimatize to every new
yes.
station.
Yes.
Ma'am, from Bangalore, Allahabad, everywhere.
Everywhere. Me too. We are going all over India. From one place to another place. What are the biotic and abiotic components? And
Ma'am?
Give examples.
Mom?
Give examples.
Mom?
Yes, Devanshi?
Mom, the biotic components are animals and plants, and the abiotic components are water, clouds, air, and that?
Biotic components are the components which are all the living organisms are regarded as biotic components, and the non-living organisms are called abiotic components. And then you are going. Yes, Dipta, what happened? Bolo.
Yes, ma'am. So abiotic components are the non-living things present in the surroundings, and ma'am, the and ma'am, biotic components are the living organisms, and the examples of biotic components are like animals and
plants and animals. Plants and animals.
And ma'am, the non-living things like bottle, paintbrush, dictionary,
but no. These are the artificial one. Natural, you have to say water, soil, light. Water, soil, light. These are natural. Artificial, no. You are all dealing about natural components, okay? Biotic and abiotic. Okay. Next, how are the trees in the mountain region adapt in the prevailing condition? Anyone else? Please. Aryan, am I audible? Aryan, I'm not able to see your video today. Why?
Ma'am, he has not turned on his video since the morning.
What happened? Because Aryan aisa to nahi hota hai Aryan se. Yes. Agam, you are able to answer?
Ma'am,
I want to say something about like in mountain regions, the trees are like in a triangular shape, in coney shape.
They are having, so I think you are able to do, they are having coney shape so that the snow or ice. Yes, Ditta.
Ma'am, they have
cone shape.
So, bolo Shivam, just wait, Ditta. Shivam will answer. Shivam, give the answer. Arpit, kahan? Arpit is also not responding.
Ma'am, yes. They are normally cone shaped and having sloping branches.
Yes.
Ma'am?
And? Yes, Devanshi.
Ma'am, the leaves are actually coated with a waxy layer so that the rain and the snow can easily slide off.
Slide off and cannot damage also. Cannot damage.
Cannot damage the leaves.
I'm actually born in Himachal, so I've seen a lot of these mountain trees.
Okay. Ma'am, I've gone to Srinagar, Gulmarg.
Okay, next is the difference between prey and predator and blowholes. You're able to. I'm not explaining that. Okay? Be in the class. And complete writing.